What's up, JD Aliens? Welcome back to my lair. Today, I want to talk to you about projectors. Now, while they've all been pretty good, there's only one that's been able to remain in my house as my home projector, and that's been the Vankyo Leisure 510. The reason why I liked it is because even though it wasn't native 1080p, it just had such a quiet fan with a really, really nice image, and I just really appreciated that. But since then, Vankyo came out with the Performance 600, which was great, because it was native 1080p, but it had a really loud fan. Now they've got the Performance 620 out, and let me tell you, since I got it, I couldn't get that Leisure 510 out of my ceiling fast enough.
Let's do it.
Let's take a look at it right now. So you get your standard Vankyo nice super portable bag here. I don't really take my projectors anywhere like to do presentations and stuff, but if you ever needed to, you can just dismount it from whatever you got it connected to, slap it in this bag with all the accessories, and it's going to be a very, very portable projector because it's actually pretty lightweight and it's not a huge projector. So once you get this thing open, let me just open it for you to see. You see the projector right here. It is a totally redesigned projector versus the Performance 600 or V600. So let me put that to the side because I want to show you some accessories. Not only do you get the bag, which I really like Vankyo providing that, but you get all these accessories. First of all, you got to have the remote. It's the standard Vankyo remote. Got some company branding right there, but you got all your buttons right there, including power, mute, and your D-pad right there, your menu, and your input selector, even volume and stuff like that. And you're definitely going to need some AAA batteries to go in here. It takes two of them. I always take this as a huge bonus. You get an HDMI cable to go with your projector. And of course, you're going to need this thing right here. This is your power plug. This is your DC power connector right here. Plug this side into the projector, this side into the wall, and you are fired up and ready to go. And right here, this is your video input cable. So you got your 3.5 millimeter right there. You got left and right for audio. And then you got your video right here, which will plug into the back of the projector. And right here, you have your VGA cable, which they actually provide. I think this is a first as far as Vankyo. I don't remember getting these in any of my Vankyo projectors. So they actually provide that. That way you don't have to go to the store and spend your life savings on extra stuff to hook up your projector if you're using this type of interface. Since we just got done talking about all those cables, let me show you right here. You got your HDMI 1 and HDMI 2. You got your AV for this cable that they give you right here. You got your Y/PB/PR input. You got an audio out. There's your VGA port right there. And last but not least, you got your two USB inputs right there. And then there's your power input. Now, taking it around to the side, you'll see your first speaker right here. It has dual stereo speakers. I guess dual is stereo. But yeah, you got two speakers in this bad boy. And let me tell you, they sound good. Oh man, they sound good. Chances are you're probably gonna be hooking this up to like a home theater or something like that. But if you're actually using this thing as a portable device, then you're definitely gonna want to utilize these speakers because these have gotta be some of the best speakers I've ever heard in a projector. They usually don't care about the speakers, but Vankyo hooked it up in here. If you come around to the top right here, you'll see another interface where you have your power button. This looks like an IR blaster. You got your D-pad right there, very tactile buttons, a menu and an input button. And then we kind of slide it back here and then you'll see your keystone, which will give you a 15 degree keystone either way. And then there's your focus ring right there. Since this is a manual focus right here, I want to show you something real quick. As you manually focus this thing, you'll see that the lens actually backs in and comes out of the projector. So that will affect the way you have to mount this thing. So when you mount it, don't just mount it when it's not focused. You must focus it first before you mount it. So that's just something to be aware of as you're mounting it, because you don't want to get it into a good spot and then it's not focused. And then once you actually focus it, you need to scoot the projector forward or back a little bit just to compensate. That might not work out so well for you. But just in case you bring this thing out too far, it does have an option in the menu where you can actually reduce the screen size down to 75%. Flipping this thing over, you get to see that gigantic lens that it has. Man, I cannot wait to fire this thing up. Oh, I've been using it for about a week now, and let me tell you, the movies on this thing look great, but I'm gonna talk about that in a minute. I just can't wait to get to it. I know you want to see some more specs and stuff like that. But here you got another IR receiver, that way the remote can work from two different sides of this thing. You got your fans flanking this bad boy, and let me tell you, this fan is just as quiet as the Leisure 510, and that's why I like it so much. The picture is just a little better, but that fan is just as quiet. So in my living room, it sits right over my head as I'm on the couch. So I can't tolerate some super loud fan from the projector interrupting my movie watching. On the bottom, once you take off the little rubber feet, you'll see these screws right here. I only needed to take three of them out because that's how my projector is mounted on my ceiling. I've already got it matched up. And then you'll just put these screws back in there and then you can seal and mount your projector. So now I get to tell you how awesome this thing has been to watch over this last week. I'm casting on a 120-inch screen, although this thing will get down to about 45 inches and all the way up to a 200-inch screen. Being that it's a 1080p image, you don't see any pixelation until you get like face to face with the screen. But once you're sitting on your couch watching this thing at a reasonable distance, all you see is a crystal clear image. And I managed to get mine focused really well to where I didn't have to use too much of the 15 degree keystone, and all four corners of my image are actually focused and also the center as I'm watching my movies and stuff. What I really like about the performance series from Vankyo is that they get super bright. This thing boasts 5,500 lux at a 5,000:1 color contrast. So what that means is you don't have to have the room pitch black in order to enjoy the content. In a mildly dim room, you could actually showcase a PowerPoint and watch games and stuff like that, so you can actually have some ambient lighting in the room. And I really appreciate that because we have a big window above our staircase that we have not covered yet, so I always have ambient light casting in there and I can still enjoy the content while it's daytime outside. I'll tell you what, for the money you spend on this thing, you cannot do any better. This is definitely the best value in a projector at this price range. It's just not gonna get any better than this. You've got the brightness, you've got the 1080p, you've got all the inputs, you got dual stereo speakers, you've got a great clean image, and one of my favorite things about this projector is it's quiet. That fan, it's quiet enough to where it's not gonna get on your nerves as you're watching your content. I'm telling you, man, best bang for the buck. If you're in the market for a projector and you got a couple of bills to spend, spend it on the Vankyo Performance V620. I guarantee you, you're gonna be sending me like thank you letters in my comments and stuff like that. Anyways, I ain't no expert on this kind of stuff, but I do like watching content on a big screen. But as far as getting the best bang for your buck in a projector, this is the one. But if you had a good time checking out this video with me, make sure you throw those emoji hands up in the comment section, and I'll see y'all at the next one. Hey, where you going? No. Sit back down. We got to talk about this. You didn't have a good time? All right, then. Hit the subscribe button. There you go. Reach down there. There you go. And then hit the bell because you need to know when I'm opening up more new stuff. You got to come right back here and check this stuff out. Now, don't you feel like a better human being? All right, I knew you would. All right, man. I'll see you soon.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?